everybody.
I have been playing with a very, very tiny GPS module called PA1010D. And this is the first time that I've been playing with a GPS module. And that's why when I saw the raw data come in, I was a little excited. And at the same time, I was like, what are these raw data? And that's why I will be digging into these raw data in this episode, try to understand what they are and extract the relevant information such as latitude, longitude, timing, altitude, and even number of satellites that this tiny module can connect to. So for the very first section, let's dive into this module, which is called PA1010D. I got this directly from the manufacturer CD Top Technologies. And if we visit their website, we will see the features here along with the link to the data sheet. Now in the data sheet, I want to point out to two sections. One of them is the pin configuration. Here we see the details of the 10 pins, and we are especially concerned about the TX and the RX pin along with the VCC and the ground pin that we will be using for the UART protocol. The next section that we will be using or referencing is section number 4 for reference design. This is where we will learn how to connect this tiny little module to some other components such as some pull-up or pull-down resistors, some decoupling capacitors that I used to make my custom PCB. Now, this is exactly how my custom PCB looks like. As you can see, I made some mistakes, so I had to bodge it with some external resistors and coupling capacitors. But other than that, once I had this custom PCB made, I was good to go. So for the next step, I had to figure out the UART connections. So for the UART connection, I made use of this board, which is a USB UART board based on the chip CP2102 from Silicon Labs. And this board basically has the TX and the RX pin along with the ground and the VCC that we will be using. So if we look at the schematic to simplify what we are doing, this is the GPS module. Now, once again, I have a couple of pull-up resistors and a couple of decoupling capacitors that I got from the reference design. And the TX line is basically connecting to the RX of the USB UART bridge. That's about it. And later on, I will also probe the TX RX line with the logic analyzer as well as the ground pin. Now note that the logic analyzer, I will be using channel 0 for the TX to the RX line. So once I have this very, very simple setup, the GPS module via 3 wires to the USB UART pin, I'll be connecting it to my laptop and then probing it with a logic analyzer to actually see the data coming in. For this, I am using Celier, the logic analyzer. So this is how it looks like, basically just probing 2 lines, the ground and the TX RX line. So inside the logic analyzer, I'll just ensure that I choose async serial and channel 0. Because that is the TX RX line, and that's about it. So after saving the settings, I will press play, start to capture the signals that are coming in. And it looks like every second the GPS is streaming in some data. So after we expand the data, we'll see lots of comma with square waves. And after it's decoded, we will also see some start of the NEMA sentences. For example, $GLGSA. If we sort of zoom out once again and zoom into, say, another area, we will also see another NEMA string. For example, $GNGGA, comma. Now, this is sort of giving us a glimpse of what are NEMA sentences. But to see it in totality, let's open up the serial monitor. So once again, in my serial monitor, I'll ensure that I choose the right port. In this case, it is Silicon Labs USB to UART, and 9600 is the baud rate, and let's connect it. So you will see something very similar to what we saw in the logic analyzer. So let me disconnect it. Here you'll see lots of commas and you will see GLGSA dollar, and we will also see GNGGA. Now for our purpose, GNRMC will be the most important. From this data, you're wondering, how do I get the exact latitude, longitude and other information out? So for this purpose, we will refer to something called the NEMA sentences. Now NEMA stands for National Marine Electronics Association. It kind of makes sense because GPS data is used for navigation initially. There are two websites that I like to use when parsing the NEMA strings or sentences. For example, this is NEMA Revealed, and over here you have the start of the strings here. For example, GNGGA. If we click this, here you will see that the entire line is expanded and they will tell us exactly what each of the commas stands for. Let's search for RMC, which stands for Recommended Minimum Navigation Information. And this is where you'll find something like latitude, longitude, speed over ground. There is also the UTC time of the position. Some very, very interesting data. The other website that I like to refer is the GPS NEMA sentence information. Over here, you will also see something very similar. Let's look at GPRMC. In fact, the first two letters doesn't really matter. So let me click that and you will also see very, very similar information. Dollar GPRMC followed by some comma separated values, and they are explained right here what they are. Now, the other place that we should look into what these NEMA sentences are is, in fact, in the data sheet itself, and it's in section number 3, where it's known as the NEMA output sentences, because this is exactly what the module will tell us. And these are all what the start of the strings look like: GNGGA, GSA, and RMC. Now, in the next segment, we will try to get a GPS fix. Now for here, because I'm indoors, when I am connecting this GPS module and streaming in the data, it does not have a fix, which means to say it does not have the latitude, longitude, or the position of where I am. That's because I'm indoors. It is not exposed to the outdoors and it doesn't have any connection to the satellite. So for this purpose, I have a pre-recorded serial monitor streaming in the data. So let's have a look at it. So I went to the park on 1st January. Look at the time, 7:18 p.m. And this is where the NEMA sentences are streaming in with lots of commas initially. And soon you will see lots of values, and there you see the latitude longitude values are streaming in right here. Now I have already captured this data into a text file, and let's dig in right from the top. So as you can see, for the first few seconds, the GPS module did not have a fix because it first got started. And then towards the end, you will see that it is starting to have some information. And when we come right to the end, after about 10 to 20 seconds, this is where we will zoom in and try to extract the data. So why don't we copy this sentence once again, which is the GNRMC sentence. And out of this, let's try to extract some information. Once again, if we refer to the website on what the RMC sentence stands for, the first one is the time of fix in UTC. So if you look at the time here, it is 11:23:17. So I have a website here which converts from UTC to another time zone. For in this case, I am in Singapore, so I'm going to use UTC to SGT time converter. So let's do 11:23 and then let's convert. And here you see it is giving us 7:23 p.m. And if we remember the time, it was around about 5 minutes thereabout, around 7:19, 7:20 p.m. So this is exactly the time that is matching in UTC according to my time zone. Let's look at a few more interesting data that we can get out of these NEMA sentences. For example, as part of GNGGA, after the time in UTC, this is where we will get our latitude and longitude. So let me quickly drop this down. This is where lat long will be there. As you can see, this is about 1 degree north and about 103 degree east. And as part of GNGGA, if you go on, after that, we will see the number 1. And once again, if we come to what the GGA string means, 1 basically means it's a GPS fix. So data is from a GPS fix. The next number is interesting. It is actually the number of satellites. In our case, if we come back, we will see that the number 4 is appearing. So number 4 will be the number of satellites. And then we will see 3.55. And that is basically horizontal dilution of precision. I have no idea what this is. But the next number is altitude. How many meters above the sea level? And here it says I am minus 22 below the sea level. It seems 22 meters below the sea level. And the next number is height of GOID, ellipsoid. I also do not know what is this. But these are some of the interesting information you have. The latitude, longitude, the fix, the UTC time, the number of satellite, altitude, and so on and so forth. So after we have found out the speed, the latitude, and longitude, the last step is to take this value and drop it in Google Maps. So for this, once again, we will go to the NEMA sentence GNRMC and let's copy out the latitude and longitude. So I'm going to copy this and drop it straight onto Google Maps and let's press enter. And it will say it cannot find. Well, that's because we need to separate it by the degree and the minute. So 1 degree north, 24 minutes. Let's put a space in between N and the numbers. And once again, 103 and then space. I'm also going to remove the comma. Let's press enter now. And there you see, this is where I am. And Google Maps will also convert the latitude, longitude into degree, minutes, and seconds instead of the decimal point here. And now let's find out where we are. So I'm going to really zoom out. As you can see, I am at the tip of the Malaysian Peninsula in Singapore. That's how we kind of extract some relevant data out of the NEMA sentences that are streaming in through the GPS model. It's pretty fun to look at it for the first time when you see the raw data. But if we are truly incorporating this GPS module into our project, there are already parsing libraries available that will get us the relevant information. We do not have to hand code it in our firmware. And that's exactly what we will be looking at in the next video, where we'll be using the Arduino firmware, connect this GPS module to a microcontroller, and then see the relevant data out. So I'll see you in the next video for some interesting play with this GPS module.